This conference will now be recorded.
Now prayer song.
Gananayakaya Ganadevataya Ganadhyakshaya Dhimahi Gunashariraya Gunamanditaya Guneshanaya Dhimahi Gunadhitaya Gunadishaya Gunapravishtaya Dhimahi एकतंदाय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय बालचंद्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि एकतंदाय वक्रतुंडाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशाय बालचंद्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि
Ma'am?
Yes, sir. Hope I am audible.
I can introduce.
Good afternoon, everybody. The resource person for the next session is Dr. G. Sudha. Let me take the privilege of introducing her. Dr. G. Sudha received her bachelor's degree in engineering from Bharatiya University in 2003, and she has attained her ME degree in engineering from Annamalai University in 2005, and she received her doctoral degree from Anna University in 2018. And to her credit, she has around 6 research articles in various national and international journals. She has attended more than 30 training programs like workshops, meetings, and courses. She has also guided more than 15 projects in UG and PG level. She has applied for 3 patents, which are under process. Her area of research includes sensors, control systems, process control, and biomedical instrumentation. Dr. G. Sudha has more than 15 years of teaching experience, and currently she is working as professor and head of the department in Department of Biomedical Engineering at Muthaiyammal Engineering College, Rasipuram, Tamil Nadu. So we are really fortunate enough to have such a knowledgeable person as our resource person for this session. Thank you. I request Dr. G. Sudha to take over the proceedings. Thank you, madam. Thank you, Ananda.
Ma'am, Sudha ma'am. Ma'am, I have shown you the presenter. Ma'am, you got the screen button. Ma'am, able to present? Ma'am, any problem is there? Sudha ma'am. Sudha ma'am. Sudha ma'am, are you there? Sudha ma'am, are you hearing? Sudha ma'am. On your mic and speak. Sudha ma'am is there, joined. Participants, let us wait for some time. Let the resource person join.
This conference will now be recorded.
Because of some network issues, I couldn't able to join for last 1 hour. So I have been joined through mobile. Even though if the presentation is not that much visible or clarity, kindly ask all the participants to be adjusted with this. So today's topic, we are going to see about smart sensors. how the smart sensors has been used in a medical field. As I belong to biomedical department, so I will be sharing you some of ideas or some of the sensors how it is using in a medical field. So I can say it as a smart sensors can, sir.
Ma'am, please video sometime, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Just 5 minutes, you can continue that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Yes. Now your PPT, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, now can everyone can able to see the PPT?
Yes.
I think so.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now it is good.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. So today's class we are going to see about. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. So today's class we are going to see about this smart sensors, how it can be a better solution in the healthcare sectors, because nowadays many people are getting that health awareness when compared to it last 2 decades or 3 decades back. Because each and everything, each and every aspects nowadays, we are thinking about this, how to take care of about ourselves, even from the small kid, the infant to elderly peoples, we are caring about ourselves, our parents, our neighborhoods, everywhere. Yes. So how the smart sensors can be a better solution in this healthcare sectors? So first we are going to see about this introduction. We already know what is a smart sensor. So smart sensor is nothing but it takes the input from the physical environment. It takes the input and it perform the function what we have given. Simply saying as what the program we have given there, and according to the program we have designed, and we will be getting the output. So that is called as a smart sensors. So this smart sensors has been mainly used for monitoring and controlling mechanisms. It has been used in overall field everywhere. We are depending upon the smart sensors. Even nowadays, more research is going in this agri. As we India have a backbone of agriculture, there are so many researches going under this agri field. Then nowadays, because of this flood, how to analyze this flood? There we are using the smart sensors. Then for environmental controlling, then for traffic monitoring, and even energy auditing, how to consume our energies, building energies, that is electrical energies, all these things. Likewise, it has the smart area has been elaborated in all areas. Recent trend, it has also been merged in this healthcare sector, that is the health science department also. So actually how it works, so it depends upon the microprocessor, inbuilt microprocessor or microcontroller, where we can do all the programs. So here it will be having four functions. One is that one, it will be converting the core conversions, that is if we are depending upon a digital input, then you will be having analog to digital, that you will be having interfacing functions, then you will be having all calculations, all these things. Yes, so it has mainly, it has four main functions. One is called as your measurement, second is called as your configuration, third is called as verification, and finally it is called as communication. So we all know what does mean by measurement, that is we are going to detect some physical signals. So how this physical signals can be detected? So basically all smart sensors will be having the characteristic of a transducer. So that is from transducer, it is sensor, then it has been changed as a smart sensors. So basically all smart sensors will be an transducer. So transducer is nothing but it converts any physical quantity into an electrical signal. So based on that application, measurements, what are the physical parameters we are giving, all the physical parameters will be measured. So the second is called as your configurations. So configuration is an important part because it depends upon how our output will be. So how we are going to have our output. So the configuration designing part is called as your configuration. That is, it allows all the signals, it detects and removes a signal, removes the noise signals or some other unwanted signals. All these things will be happening. That is called as signal conditionings will be happening in this configurations, and then it will remove all the errors, and finally it will be given to the verifications. So in verifications we will be having that sensors, how it will be implemented. So what type of sensors we want to implement. For example, our day-to-day life, even you take that water level sensor, which is a very common basic sensors where we are using in a home appliance. So here we will be having So we all know about that water level sensors. We will be having some set point, we will be having a low level set point, and we will be having the higher level set point. So if the water is going below the low value, then alarm will be given. If it goes above the high value, then the alarm is given. So that is one of the basic example we can give for the smart sensor which we are using in day-to-day life. Like that, so many sensors we are using in our day-to-day life. Next comes the communications. So the communication is nothing but the interaction between the sensors and the programmers or the controllers. So it can be communicating between the sensors and the programmers. So it can be either microcontroller, microprocessor, microcontroller. Now so many advanced are going, like Arduinos, then we are going for some Bluetooth technologies, all these things. So what we can simply say is that smart sensor is nothing but it is the sensor plus integrated circuits will be called as your smart sensors. So basically sensors, what I have said, it works on the application, it works on the principle behind the transducer, that is converting of a physical quantity into an electrical quantity. Then integrated circuits, we all know what is integrated circuits. That is basically we will be having that integrations of all that components, like electronic components. Basically we will be having that op amps, then we will be having resistors, capacitors, all these things are, we can simply say it as RL circuits, or that, like that we will be saying as integrated circuits. So here we are depending upon that some communication systems, what I have said before, that is microprocessor, microcontroller, or even nowadays we are depending upon Arduino. Yes. Next comes the smart sensor. So the smart sensor is, how they are saying is that it has its own micro brain. So what is this micro brain? Is nothing but the program what we have given there, what we have programmed inside the microprocessor or microcontroller. For example, if I want to detect some object, so red color object, so I will be programming according to that to that analysis. That is, I want to detect only the red color object, so remaining objects it will not detect, remaining colors it will not detect. So this is how I am going to write the program. So that program is called as a micro brain. So general architectures of smart sensor, we have sensing element, that is transducers, then amplifier, sample and hold circuit. So sample and hold circuit is used for A to D converters, that is from converting analog into digital signals. Then we have analog multiplexers, we have analog to digital converters, offset, then digital to analog memory, serial communications and processors. So these are the elements which is present in the architecture of smart sensors. So this is the architecture of a smart sensor, where we have a transducer. From transducer it is given to amplifier, from there it is converted to SNH, that is a sample and hold circuit, and from there it is given to multiplexer, from multiplexer it is A to D converter, from there it is going to processor, all these process, and finally we will be having the output. Is So this sensor have mainly 5 ports. That is, one is called as your central processing unit. Second is called as battery. Then third is called as transceiver, memory, communication module. So what does mean by central unit? So we know what is central unit. What in system, if we are using a computer, we will be saying a central processing unit. Yes, where we can perform all type of functions. Yes, here also the central processing is nothing but it can be a control part. That is, it can be a processor part. We will be using either microprocessor, microcontroller, Adreno, or whatever it may be. So that is called as a central processing, where it can manage all the tasks like addition, subtraction, or even I can program it. I can use some short programs or long programs or whatever. I can able to function anything. So that is called as a central processing unit. Next is the transceiver. So it interacts with the environment. That is, it interact with the input and the sensor part. Okay, and it collect what it want to receive. So it will collect all the data and it will finalize and it will be given to the output section. So that is called as transceiver. So memory is used to store all the data. We know we as a human being, we will also have a long term memory, short term memory, all type of memories we have. And sometimes we can able to recall what happened at our childhood. So that is called as memory. So that is happening in our human being. Likewise, if we want to store the data in a system, then we will be depending upon the memory. Is then come then next comes the communication module. So the communication module is nothing but the interaction between the transceivers, and it will be receive interaction between the transceivers and the central processing unit. So that is called as your communication. Simply, we will be saying no. Two parts. So two end we will be having. One will be the transmitter side and another one will be the receiver. So this both transmitter and the receiver section is called as your communication module. So the next we are going to see about the types of smart sensors. So here we can able to see so many types of sensors like color sensors, gas sensors, LDR, rain sensors, ultrasonic sensors. So we have also seen so many sensors, what like level sensors, electric current sensors, pressure sensor, temperature. So when saying about this temperature sensors, I will we have seen so many advanced technologies, how the technology has been improved, because a decade, that is 10 years back or even 20 years back, nearly 30 years back, if you take a that clinical thermometer, if a patient is having fever, if he is going to hospital, they want to check the temperature. So what they will be using is that they will be using basic clinic thermometer. So what that clinical thermometer, you will be having a simple like this, and you will be having a red color mercury inside that. So they will be having 3 or 4 thermometers. So the same thermometers they will be keeping for each patient under the tongue, or under the armpit, all that data. So there may be the possibility of infections. Yes, so they will be using the same thermometer. Then after the seeing the temperature for 5 days, for they will be keeping us for 5 minutes observation. So that mercury will be increasing. Then they will be noting down what is our temperature. Again, they will be cleaning with the cotton, and they will be keeping with the cool water, so that the temperature, that so that the mercury again will come back to its position. Again, they will be using the same thermometer to some other patient. So there is possibility of infections. So now, but what happens today is the we are using digital thermometer, that is the temperature sensors. So there is no need to touch the body. At a distance itself, we can able to monitor the temperature of a person. So because of this COVID impact, no, so each and everywhere, even schools, colleges, shopping malls, or wherever the public place is there, we are using this temperature sensors. Yes. So this is also some other type of sensors like ultrasonic sensors, gas sensors, accelerometers, flux sensors, IR transmitter, photodiodes, so microphone, Hall sensors, rain sensors, IR sensors, all these things. Yes. Actually, what are the industries getting benefit from the smart sensors? Is the first one we are going to see is that a healthcare. Second is the warehouse and manufacturing, hospitality, in office, and then in home automation. So these are main industries which is getting benefited from the smart sensors. So in this, we are going to see about how the smart sensors is get benefited or how it is used in the healthcare sectors. So one example I have given for this home automation, that is Alexa. So this is the first world location aware of IT platform. So wherever you can go, that is there is no need of any manual touch. So it will detect by our motion, that is when there is a movement in there, based on that movement, all automation process will be taking place. So that is called as a smart building. So I will show you some examples regarding this. So the next we are going to see is that a motion sensors. So here you can able to see two pictures. So in first picture there is no person, and in second picture there is a person. So what is happening in these two pictures is that you can see that electricity. So in first picture there is no need of electricity, that is the light and the fans are turned off because there is no movement of any person. But in second picture you can able to see there is a person moving, movement. So the movement is detected and you can able to see the lights are on. So this type of sensors is mostly used in hospitals in order to avoid that infections. So this is highly considered as an hygienic process in hospital. Yes. The second you are going to see is that a light sensor. So here also you can able to see two pictures. This is a light based. So depending upon the daylight based thing, based on the light, that is based on the sunlight. So the first picture they are working at a night. You can able to see they have closed the windows. So they have closed the windows. When they have closed the windows, there is more darkness. So they are depending upon 80% of light energy. So they are depending upon 80% of energy level. But when the windows are opened, see the light usage is only 30%. So we can have more energy consumptions when we are using this light sensor. So based on this, you can say it as a smart buildings. Nowadays, more buildings, they are using smart sensors to find out the fractures, because many buildings, the infrastructure is very different, because we have seen many buildings with the different infrastructures in Saudi areas where the each and every building is different, as then there is so many optical illumination buildings have been done. So all these are mainly based on this smart sensor. So even if there is a very tiny crack in that building, or if the structure is there is any misplacement or misalignment of any structures, then it can be detected by using all these smart sensors. So the next we are going to see about why the smart sensors are used in a biomedical application. So what is the need of this smart sensor? So how it is used, what is the need? We can say it as it can be used for processing the data, that is it can be an assisting doctor. So where we can diagnostic, we can have self diagnosis, we can able to detect ourselves, we can monitor ourselves. Continuous monitoring will be there if we are depending upon this smart sensors. Then we are using more highly intelligent medical equipments, because nowadays there is nano robotics. Then we are depending upon that robotic surgeries. Then if you want to find it out our internal, if there is any damage or if there is any abnormalities in our internal organs, we are depending upon nanobots. Yes, so it will be like a capsule, a small capsule which will be of a nano size. So all these nanobots are depend upon nanotechnologies. Inside there you will be having camera, you will be having the sensors. So we can take that nanobots like tablets, how we are taking normally we are taking. So when it gets inside, it can be, we can see our internal organs through our camera. So this is how the doctors can able to find it out whether we are having any stomach cancers, or we are having any intestine cancers, gastric cancers, all these things. So that is one example we can say for smart sensors, how it is used for continuous monitoring. Then robotics, how it sends, all these things are coming under that smart sensors. Apart from this, there are some primary sensors which we are using in our medical field, which is used to monitor the pressure, force, airflow, oxygen, pulse oximetry, then temperature, barcode sensing. So what are these? So we know pressure, BP, what we are generally seeing as blood pressure. So here we have three type of patients. That is, one is called as a normal people who are having 80-120. Then a low pressure BPs, so this will be less than 80 and less than 120. Then high BP peoples will be greater than the normal range. So this is how we can able to monitor ourselves. So the thing, you just consider a situation, something unnervous, something nervous, nervous situation, or some uncertainties, or suddenly we have been caught, or some accidents we have seen. So at that time we can feel our heartbeat, it will be beating very fast. So at that time, if we measure our pressure, normally it will not be 80-120, it will be very high. So that is how we can able to monitor ourselves. There are so many smart applications are available, smart watches are there. Then even our, we are having many applications in our smart mobiles. So if you are going for walking, then we can able to count how many steps we have taken, then how many liter of water we have taken per day, how many calories of food we have taken a day. So all these things can be an examples of these smart sensors, how we are using in our day-to-day life. Then barcoding sensing is, we have been seen in hospitals. When we are entering into hospitals, we will be having that reception area, or we will be saying as the hospitality area. There they will be entering all our details. They will be asking all our details. What is our name? What is our age? What is our gender? Where we are from? What is our mobile? Whether we are having any family or heredity diseases, or this is the first time. So all data they will be entering in that system. And they will be giving us a barcode for us. They will be tying a barcode in our hand. So that by using that barcode, you can meet the doctor. So if you show that barcode, what are the prescriptions given by doctor, it will be stored in your personal data. Okay. So there is no need of carrying or remembering the prescriptions, what they have given before. So maybe we have been... forgot to take the prescription sheet of what we have taken before. Yes, sir, so many incidents have been happened like that. So even if we are not satisfied with this treatment, then we can go for the second treatment, or we can go for second hospitals. So when you are going for that hospitals, by using this barcode, you can able to transfer the data from hospital one to hospital two. So there is no need of carrying all your files, your historical data, your medical records, all these things. Only by using your barcode, you can transfer everything. So likewise, so many applications, so many usages are there in a biomedical field. Yes. So another thing nowadays, we are using for cancer treatment, we are able to find out which is the cancer tissues. So finding out for the cancer tissues, screening. So in olden days, you take an example for x-rays, we want to wait for 2 days. If you want to scan, if you want to go for scanning, then we want to wait, we want to put that token, then they will be asking us to come for 1 day or second day, then we will be wait for that report, another 2 days we want to wait for that report. So but now it is not like that, it is takes only 10 minutes, because of this technological advancement in the, or the technological improvement what we have been using today, or what we are being comforted with it. Next we can say, even for blood samples, if we want to know our blood group, we want to go to the hospital, then we want to give a 5 ml of blood to them, to the lab, then what they will be doing, They will be asking us to come next day or another 2 days. But now there is no need of going all these things because there is a plate which is used to detect our group. Yes, so there is no need to wait for 1 day or 2 days. So totally there is a total controller, total count controller system is there where you can able to have your collection of blood. That is a minimum you want to have a 10 ml of blood in the total counter in total counter kit. So if you give that 10 ml of blood inside that, total your RBC counting, WBC counting, what is your HP count, whether we have any pus cells, whether what we say, what is our glucose level, whether we are having bilirubin or ketones or whatever the things, all parameters, all 14 parameters of our blood, that is blood plasma, what is the thickness of the blood, everything, the 14 parameters of the blood can be analyzed. So all these are possible because of this smart sensors. Then another thing, we can say it as a scan centers, that is MRI scan, CT scan. Even if there is any problem, that is the people who are mentally disabled, that is the people who are suffering from stress or who are depressed, so by using that EEG, that is electrogram meter, by using EEG you can able to analyze all the brain activities. If you are having any eating disorder or if you are having any sleep disorder, so all activities can be analyzed. Even if I am talking, so how much stress I am using, so what is the voice I am using, so everything can be analyzed by using this smart sensor. So there are so many applications of the smart sensors. Okay, so next we are going to see about some examples of this smart sensors. One is called as your biosensors. So biosensors can be used during the pregnancies and during the ultrasounds, that is to find it out whether the fetus is normal or any deficient or some any defect is there. All these things can be find it out whether the fetus is healthy at an age, at an a week of 12 or in the first three weeks or in the first trimesters or second trimesters or third trimesters. So nowadays they are calculating like that. So first three semesters they will be giving, they will be analyzing, they will be asking us to come for 1 month once for a scanning, and they will be asking us to take more folic acids, and they will be checking the water level, they will be checking our heartbeat. So everything is analyzed. So in the month of fifth, they will be going for the ultrasound, and they will be checking about the organs of that fetus, that is whether there is any deficient, whether there is any defect in that physical organs, whether the eyes are very well. They will be checking about the spinal cord, backbone, bones, how the legs and hands are there, what is the hearing capacity, everything they will be checking in the month of five by using this ultrasound scans. Next comes the pressure sensors. So pressure sensors we will be using for the oxygen concentrations. So many things, many cases we have seen in last 2 years because of this pandemic, COVID pandemic, yeah, we have seen because of oxygen deficiencies, that is because of this oxygen deficiency many people have died, they have been lost their valuable life that because of shortage of this ventilations. There is no proper equipments or proper treatment, all these things we have seen. So what is this oxygen concentrator? Is that we will the oxygen what we are using in the hospital will be called as a liquid oxygen. That oxygens will be passed through that tube, tubelets which has been from the outside to inside. That is especially those have gone for this cardiac arrest or some other surgeries. Even in the operation theaters, they will be using this oxygen pipeline. So by using this oxygen pipeline, they will be supplying that liquid oxygen to the patient who is in need. So the people who can't have their own breath, who can't have their own breath, they will be depending upon this ventilator. So ventilators, I want to check whether the oxygen level is right, is correct or not. Is there any problem? So all these things I can able to monitor continuously by using this pressure sensors. Another thing, the people who is in ICC unit, that is in a critical cardiac critical unit. So the people who have went for a bypass surgery or some other cardiac problems, so they want to monitor for 24 hours continuously if there is any drop in them or if there is any minute change. All these things can be analyzed by using this biosensors or maybe pressure sensors, temperature sensors, and then comes the image sensors. So that is we will be using mainly used in the cardiac cardiology. That is we will be analyzing whether our heart is functioning, our heart is functioning correctly or not, if there is any block inside our heart or inside our veins. So many we have been heard about the block, blood clot. Yes, if there is any blood clot, that we may have many deficiencies. We may have many abnormalities. So one thing we can say it as the people who is having a blood clot at an elderly age, that is the people at an age of 670 and above, they will have the stroke problem, that is called as the paralysis. Either they will have an phase paralysis, that is either the phase will not function correctly, or they will be having the right side paralysis or left side paralysis. If there is any problem, if any block inside our heart, they can't have a sufficient breathing problem, they will be having breathing problem, they will have sugar problems, everything is there. So mainly the people who is having the sugar or the people who is in under the diabetic people, so they will be always want to check their pressure level because they doesn't know the pain. The people who are suffering from diabetic, they can't able to feel that pain. So that's why they always they will be having a continuous checkup of their pressure early morning. So whenever they are waking up daily, no, early morning, so they will be having that pressure check. So if the pressure is normal, then there is no problem. If it is abnormal, then they want to go for any treatment if required. Yes. So the next we are going to see is that a wearable device. So today's emerging field is called as the wearable device. So wherever we are going, we are seeing many devices. Even it was like a minute, we can put it as an ear stud. We can have it in our hand, like wrist watches or ring, like even textiles, that is e-textiles we are having. So all these things are called as the wearable device. So apart from this, how this smart sensors can be used, like that it can be used as a wearable motion sensors for medical applications, wearable sensors for monitoring the physiological parameters, because our body has a physiological parameters like ECG measurement, EMG measurement, EOG measurement, and EEG measurement. That is, we can able to analyze our heart functioning of heart, that is called as ECG. Then comes EEG, that is our brain activities, functioning of brain activities is called as EEG. Next is called as EOG, that is a functioning of our retinas. So how our eye works, we will be checking about our eyeballs, whether a retina is there or whether we are having any problems in our, whether there is any problem in the veins of eyes, all these things, the movement, whether we are having any tissues, external tissues present inside our eyes, all these things will be monitored by using your EOG. And EMG is used to measure the activities of our muscles, because this will be used in a physiotherapy department, especially the people who is under the rehabilitations. Yes, so many people who have been unexpectedly fallen down or who may have had met an accident, so what they will be having is that they may lose their lost their organs, or because of some problems, that is fractures, or if it is minor fracture, then it's no issues. If it is a major fractures, then they can't able to do their work normally after that treatment. So in order to have their act, in order to have their strength and back, they will be doing this EMG analysis. Even for bodybuilders, that is the people who are in athletes in sports, they are going for this EMG. If you want to reduce your weight, then you can go for this EMG. It is that it you can't say it as totally it will reduce our weight, but it is like a muscle contraction. So the muscles will be tightened. So when they are doing that physical activity, fitness program or fitness exercise, they can measure or they can check their muscle strength by using this EMG. So all these things are called as your physiological parameters. Then comes the implantable sensors for healthcare, that is face makers, all these things, implantable face makers, implantable defibrillators, all these things is called as your implantable device. Even we have bionic arms, bionic legs. Yes, all these things is called as eye limbs. All these things are called as implantable sensors. Next comes the environmental sensors for healthcare applications. So we are detecting the any infections out there, because hospitals, any type of pills will be coming, many type of patients will be coming with unknown diseases. So there may be the possibility of spreading disease and non-spreading disease. So we want to keep our environment hygienically. So we will be using the environmental sensors to check the infectional diseases, or in order to monitor the airborne in the healthcare sectors. Next comes the sensors for monitoring the surgical procedures. So what I have said, no, robotic operations. We are depending upon the robotic operations, or if you are going for video conferencing, that is a telesurgeries. So nowadays, another one merging field is called as your telemedicine, where we can have all this telesurgery, telerehabilitations, telephysiotherapy, all these things we can be done by using the telecommunications or through this video communication. So that is called as the telemedicine. So this is the field which has been emerged, and it was totally implemented in the South Africa, because there are so many areas which are very remote in South Africa and people's not able to go there. So there will be the people, trained people, who is called as community peoples, who is called as community peoples in each area. So they will be giving birth basic nursing treatments. So they will be giving what we can say it as basic first aid. They will be taught with the basic first aid, so that they will be taking care of that particular areas. If anything happens, then that community people will communicate to the doctors through this telecommunications. So that is one area we can say it as surgical procedures or telecommunications, all these things. Next, that physical rehabilitations. So what I have said, no, EMG is used for that rehabilitations. So some sensors, if I want to lift the people who are physically, what I have said, the people who are mentally disabled, they can't do their own work, or people who are very aged people, they can't do their own work, or people who have been under the paralysis attack. So they will be connected with some smart sensors like watch, or they will be hanging some chain like that. So if they want to have something to take food, so they will be giving the sign signals. That is, if they are showing the finger like this one time, if they are moving that finger like this, so for each and every moment, the program will be coded and it will be implemented by using the embedded systems, and it will be used. So if I want to drink water, so I will be using only one movement like this. If I want to have food, then I will be folding my finger like this two times or three times. So I can shake like this. So the elder peoples or the stroke peoples can't do like that. So they will be have a slow movement like this. So whenever there is movement in that first finger, then particular program will be activated, and you can have an alarm or a voice message like that. That person need water or whatever the thing. Next comes the neuroscience, that is what we are saying as that brain activities. because nowadays that our environment, our society has made us to be in made or put us in depressions. That is, we are not in a position to accept anything. We have lost patience. So everything is there. Work pressure is there. Family pressure is there. The time management is there. We can't able to accept the people who are doing a fault. We are not ready to forgive. So all these things. So what happens is that at that time, our brain, the activities of the brain. So we have four type of waves in our brain, that is alpha, gamma, beta, and delta. So all these will be having an each waveform will be having each activity. So because when we are in total depressions or when we lose ourselves, we don't know what we are doing. So we doesn't know whether we are doing correct or wrong, whatever the thing. So in order to study ourselves, in order to study our brain activity, depending upon this neuroscience, that is it called as a totally psychological treatment, is called as your neuroscience. Studying about the brain activities of the brain and the mind, that is called as your neuroscience. So already I have given the explanation for this sensors of telemedicines. Next emerging area is called as the body area network, that is a band, which is called as body area sensors or body area network, where each and every activities. If I am placing pacemaker here, so how this pacemaker is working, whether it is implantable or externally I have given the pacemaker, or if I am using the defibrillator, whether I am using the defibrillator manually or padded defibrillator. So all these things is called as the body area network. Even if I am using socks, so we have seen grip band, all these things. So if there is any sprain in my muscles or a sprain, we are using a band. So automatically if we place that band on the sprain area, it will have a grip like this. After that, when the sprain removes, then automatically the band will be removed from our body. So that is all these things is called as your body area sensors. Next, for this continuous patient monitoring, the sensors which we will be using in ICU unit or for the home elderly people. So continuously monitoring them, because elderly people can't able to oftenly come and visit the hospital. So we will be placing the sensors at the people who are elderly people, even the infant and even a small child. We can't able to monitor the baby who is in incubator, or some premature babies, or babies which has breathing problems. So there are so many diseases which is affecting the infant babies. So in order to monitoring continuously that babies, then elderly people, other people who are suffering strokes, paralysis, all these things, there are so many undefined diseases are there. The people who is suffering from autism, that is nowadays in Western countries, the child who is under below 15, many children are suffering from this autism. Yes, so these people want to monitor continuously. So we have been designed the sensors which will be monitoring them continuously, their heart rate, their temperature, pressure, everything. If there is something abnormal, immediately the message will be given to the device which is connected with that sensor. Next is the sensors for home assessment, then metrological assessments, all these things. So the next picture shows some examples of medical applications, the sensors of medical applications based on the Honeywell company. So here you can have the ventilator solutions, oxygen concentrator solutions, infection pump solution. Then even for anesthesia, because when you are doing operations, for every five minutes, we want to check about that anesthesia, dropping of anesthesia. Because if you are giving anesthesia continuously, the people may have a deep sleep, or sometimes when it goes beyond the limit at a cause, what happens, the people may go to some coma stage, or they may not recover it properly. So all these things want to be controlled, that is especially going for that major surgery, that is for 20-hour surgery, 21-hour surgery. That is a replacement of heart transplantations. All these things during that surgeries, they will be depending upon this anesthesia solutions. Next is the dialysis solutions. Then you can have that hardware solution. So what is that hardware solution? Is that the bed? So in olden days they will be using the cot, but nowadays there is we will be using a wooden cot or a steel cot. We have been used in olden days, but nowadays you can see that medical cot. So you can bend the bed according to our position. If you want to lie down, then you can keep your bed like this. If you want to sit like this, then you can have a 45 degree angle. If you want to sit straight, then you can bend your cot as 90 degrees. So all these facilities has been done. So that is called as your hardware solutions. So next we are going to see about that wearable device. What I have said, no? So what is wearable device? Why this wearable device is used in the medical field? So what is its impact in the society? All these things we are going to see. So mainly this wearable device is used to measure the basic parameters of any human being. That is heart rate, blood pressure, body temperature, the oxygen, blood oxygen level. All these things is used to is used to monitor of any human being by using this wearable device. So another thing here I have mentioned as BCG. So what is this ballistocardiogram? So ballistocardiogram is also used to check sudden injection or ejection of blood. So many people, you can see the people who is having cough. Suddenly when they cough, they will be having the bleeding, blood bleedings. So why it cause? So whether there is any problems in the veins or arteries or all these things can be monitored by using this ballistocardiogram. That is the repeated analysis. Yes. So here I will be showing the waveform for ECG. So upper you will be having PQRS waveform. So based on this PQRS waveform, we are able to analyze whether we are having a normal heart rate or whether we are having bradycardia that or we are having tachycardia. That is a slow heart rate or fast heart rate. That is bradycardia, we will be having less than 60 beats per second, and tachycardia we will be having more than 100 beats per second. Yes, per minute. So based on this waveform, PQRS waveform, we are analyzing whether the heart functioning is correct or not. Next, you can able to see a blue color waveform, that is IJK waveform. So this is called as your ballistocardio signal. So this is used to check whether there is any bleedings in our veins or arteries. Yes. So if there is any vein, so each time when the heart beats, we will be having blood leakage. So that is used to find out the blood leakage. So these are some types of wearable devices where we are using smart ring, smart glasses, shirt, watch, key track. So many wearable devices are there, like smart shoes, socks, pants, even the dress that is we are calling as e-textiles. Then smart belt, baby controls, so that is GPRS system. We are using bracelet, smart fingers. Everywhere you are using this wearable device. Even if we want to find it out to track the baby, we are using this wearable device. If we, for this girl child safety, for our girl safety, we are using this wearable device. Like we will be having a GPS connected pendant which is connected to our chain, or we will be having bindi like this, or we can have an ear stud. So or we will be having some sensors which is connected with our handbag, which will be implemented, which is implemented with the GPRS, so that we can have a where we are. So we can say our locations and we can feel the safety. So all these things are called as smart sensors, or it is called as wearable devices. So apart from this, there are also other emerging areas in wearable device. One that is mainly we are using for analyzing. So how to avoid preventing all these things. Yes. So as we want to save the life of people, we are checking into that, whether I can use this or that or whatever the solution it may be. I want to save the patient life. Yes. So apart from this, there are some other merging areas like prevention of disease and the maintenance of health. That is called as disease and disease management. So we will be analyzing whether a flu fever, that is a flu cold, common cold, is a spreading disease or non-spreading disease. Then we will be looking into that viral fever. Yes, whether it is spreading disease or non-spreading disease, typhoid, malaria. So each and every disease will be analyzed and it will be characterized as an infectional or non-infection, that is called as spreading or non-spreading diseases. So according to that, they will be having the disease management. So what are the rectifications or what are the disinfections I want to use? So what are the methods I want to use to cure, whether it is an spreading disease or it is a non-spreading disease or whatever the thing. So that is called as the prevention of disease and the maintenance of health. Second is that fall identification and the prevention. So when saying about fall identifications and the prevention, we are working and suddenly we are falling down. So what is that? No, how we are using that life jacket when we are going for in a ship and all like that, we are having an air jacket. So that will be that can be worn by the elder people or babies or whoever it may be, even infant. From age of 0 to age of 100, we have an air bags. So what they will be having is that they can able to wear that. So when they fall down, okay, so it will be in, it can be programmed at an angle of 45, 60. Yes. So when it senses the ground, automatically the bag will be opened and they will be having an airbed like that. So this was implemented in China and it was tested. Yes. So they are recommending the elder peoples to use this airbag so that they can have that prevention, so that they can prevention of any injuries, like maybe that they can have a physical injury or bone injuries, maybe they have, maybe they lost their life. So in order to avoid all these things, they are recommending the elders to use this. Next comes the physical activity and the interaction monitoring. So physical activities, that is the people who are going for this athletic sports, they will be doing physical fitness program, physical fitness exercise, they will be running. So the people who are all in sports, they want to check about the posture. So here we have 8 type of postures. Yes, as a human being, we have 8 type of postures. So the people who is in a sports field, they will be always have a straight postures. So they will be using this wearable device if they bend like if their head is like this. So as we are using our mobile, no, always we will be looking down like this. So that what happens? A lump will be forming at this position. And we can able to feel the pain here. Some people even, they will have spams here. That is what we will call as crumbs. Yes, they will be having in that muscles. So they can't do their work properly. So we people will sit like this. So we can't able to sit like this. So that is called as the physical activities and the interaction monitorings. And then if we are doing our daily activities, if I want to pick a pen, so how much force I am using to pick my pen. So all these things is monitored. If I am carrying a 1 liter water bottle, so how much strength I am using for that one liter water bottle. If I am carrying a 5 liters, if I am carrying vessels. So each and everything is calculated by using this physical activity. Next is the mental status monitoring. So what I have said is that the brain activity. So there are so many different stresses, different from depression. Yes, and the memory loss is different from our depression, stress, all these things. There are so many stress like work tension. We doesn't know why we are worrying about. We will be thinking about the family situations and we will have some worries. So all these things will be considered. Yes, so that is called as stress, that is called as your mental status monitoring. So the next is called as the patient with a stroke. So the who is the patient with the stroke? What I have said, no? If there is any blood clot. So here we have two types of blood clot. One is that the blood which is getting inside our heart is also called as block. Another one activity is that the blood which is going to our brain. So these are the two main functions, two main reasons to cause the stroke. So if we are having block in our heart also, we will having this stroke. If we are having a block in our blood vessels which is going to the brain, because if the blood is blocked in our brain, if there is no flow of blood in our brain, all our physical activities will be stopped. That's why the people before giving the deep fibrillation, that is the people who is having this heart attack or some cardiac arrest, immediately they will be giving the CPR treatment. Yes, that is the 30 press per minute. Yes, 30 press per minute. If the people who is well trained, they will be giving 120 press per minute. So after immediately giving the CPR, they will be using for this defibrillator, so that the heart will pump automatically. Yes, so that is called as the stroke. That is the people who is having stroke, they can't move their hand like this, or they can't able to do their work normally. They want to depend upon others. So in order to avoid that, in order to monitor them, so how they are doing their work, whether they have fall down or whether they are taking their, so all these things. So in order to monitoring them, we are using this wearable device for the stroke people. Next comes the diabetic care management. As in India, we are having mostly the type 2 diabetic people. I mean, compared with Western countries, we are having type 2 diabetics, so that we are having this cardiac. If it is a type 1 diabetics, then that is the outcome, or that cost factor will be very very complex when compared with the type 2 diabetics. Yes, so here in India we are having type 2 diabetic, so that we want to monitor what I have said. We want to continuously monitor the patient, that is sugar level, blood glucose level, urine glucose level, then what is their pressure, so what is the food they have taken, what is the calories they have taken, the tablet, so everything have they taken, or if they have forgot to taken, then immediately the alarm or the signal will be sent to the device, which to the people who has been connected with that device, or sudden fatigue. The people who is having diabetic, if they are not taking food at time, no, they will feel that fatigue. So if they have any fatigue, immediately the message will be sent to the nearby hospitals or the device which has they have been connected. So that is the taking of the diabetic care management. Next comes the sports medicine. That is the people who are doing if they are running, if the people who is having an 100 meter running or 400 meter running, you can feel the heartbeat, the body heat, everything. So that and all, very, you can able to measure the basic parameters, which will be very abnormal. So it will be very high from the normal rate. So they want to cool down, or they want to come back to the normal positions. That's why we are asked, or the peoples are always asked, the children's or the other peoples who are walking fastly, or they who have been played, we are asking our children, okay, after playing, don't drink water. After running, don't drink water. Because when they have, when they take that water, no, our blood flow will be very fast. Because of that blood flow, our capillary tubes, which is inside our veins, will be very hot. So whenever we take water, immediately the capillary tubes will be burst, and there is a cause for having this cardiac arrest, or maybe the heart may stop. That's why we are asked the peoples not to take water immediately after doing any physical activities. Yes, then for weight control and monitoring, we know there are more applications in our smartphones to check the calories, what we have taken today, that is how many liters of water we have drink. So that sensors will be attached with us. That is, we can use like a wristwatch, or we can have a tag like this, or we may have a the sensors like this. Even we will be having a mouse like a device. So all these are used to monitor our weight control. Yes. Then apart from this, the people who are suffering from the brain and the spinal cord injuries, for them also we want to monitor continuously. We want to have some wearable devices, so they will be having a jacket like this, so they can sit like this straightly. The people who have gone for the spinal cord operations, they can't sit like this, so they will be using some belt to keep their position straight. So that is called some wearable device. Then chronic pulmonary patients, that is the people who has been suffered from cardiac arrest with the lung problem, that is a breathing problem. So they will be having those people will have a that is infection both in the heart as well as in the lung. So they want to monitor continuously. So that is called as chronic pulmonary patients. Then blood disorder. So your HB may be varying. There won't be any RHB, WBC cells, RBC cells. Then plasmas. Even our blood will be clot. The thickness of the blood will be varying. The blood glucose level will be high. So all these things will be coming under your blood disorders. Next comes the patient management. So the patient management is nothing but total monitoring, continuous monitoring. So if you take an example, a newborn baby. So if the newborn baby should be a 3 kg, if it is a less than a 3 kg, that is 100 gram less, what they will be doing, they will be keeping the child in the incubator for 1 hour or 2 hours. Yes, and they will be handovering that newborn baby to the mother. If it is in a surgery, okay, if it is a cesarean, then what they will be doing, they will be keeping the child for 1 day in the incubator, and then they will be giving handovering that child to the mother. So that is called as patient management. So which patient need which treatment, so how they are taking that, whether there is any improvements, so all these things will be monitored continuously. So that is called as a patient management. Next comes the cancer surveyors, because nowadays many many people are getting this cancers. Olden days, cancer is looked as in one of that the disease which cannot be controlled. Even nowadays, even small disease like leukemia, that is a blood cancers, can be treated. They are saying that it can be treated at the stage 1 or stage 2. So that cancer is a disease which cannot be treated at the stage of 4, 5, and 6. So if we have find it out the patient is having cancer at the stage 0, 1, it can be cured or it can be postponed, or their life can be postponed by giving the continuous treatment like chemotherapy. So if they are giving chemotherapy, then the radiation will be passed through that patient. So how much of radiation is passing to that patient? So what is the physical strength of that patient? If I am giving continuously that radiation, whether he can withstand? So all these things will be analyzed by using this cancer surveyors. Next comes the Parkinson's disease. So Parkinson's disease is nothing but the short-term memories, or the people's at an older age, they will forget some incidents. Okay, so that is called a short-term memory. They may forget something happened in their life. Some part of things will be can't be able to recall. So that is called as Parkinson's disease. Next is that autism, you know. Next is the depression. So all these type of diseases can be monitored continuously by using this wearable device. So this is also an emerging area where we can have a vast research area. Even we are using us, so there are so many devices at low cost. Even the students are doing many projects based on this biomedical sensors, that is biosensors, for monitoring their ECGs, and they are looking for many patterns. They are going for many patterns, the method they are using. So all these are categorized as the wearable device. So the next comes the e-textile, that is electronics in clothing, what I have said. So by using our textiles, by using our cloth, I can able to monitor what is my heartbeat, what is the blood what is my blood flow, what is the pulse rate, what is the flow, that is the heat of my body, what is the heat of my blood. So everything I can able to monitor by using this e-textile. This is also an emerging field in that hospital, in that medical care sector. Even the cloth what they are using in the hospitals, even the mask what we are using nowadays because of this COVID, they are asking us to have only use and throw mask. We want to go for N95, or there are so many herbal mask has been there. Then when with the air ventilations, the mask is there. So all these are called as the e-textiles. So most of this mask, this most of this e-textiles will be get certified from the CITRA, that is a South Indian Textile Research Association, which is located in Coimbatore. So most of these e-textiles, what we have been done, should be get certified from the CITRA, and then it will be coming into that market. Yes. So next we are going to see about how this smart sensor have been used in telemedicine. So this telemedicine is also one of the multidisciplinary research area where we can communicate to the people who is in the remote area. So the people who can't be reached through any type of transport, we can communicate them by using this telemedicine. Telemedicine, what I have given previously an example, that is South Africa, it is fully made, fully connected with this telemedicine because there are so many remote areas are there. Even in India, there are so many programs and so many hospitals has been certified by this telemedicines where they are using officially. Even our government of India has been approved this telemedicines, and it has been used in Jipmer, then AIMS, then in Apollo hospitals. All these hospitals has been supported by this telemedicines. So here also in telemedicines we can have telemonitoring, e-health, mobile health technologies. All these things will be coming under telemedicines, that is a smart home and a smart home cares. All these things will be there, that is assisting devices. The device which is used as which is used to make us to live, that is pacemakers, even that arm, but what I have said, no, bionic arm, bionic legs. All these things are called as that are smart sensors. But in telemedicine, what happens is that we can communicate through television, that is telephone, that is only telecommunications. The doctors and the patient can be communicated, like how we are asking appointment order in hospitals and we are making appointment, period appointment. Yes, so that is called as a one way of communication, telecommunication. But actually what happens in telemedicine is that the particular patient will have a continuous observation with that doctor, with a particular doctor, and they will be having continuous monitoring. So if there is any need, then they will, doctor will see through the video, through the video mode, that is through video conferencing, and they will be using the device so that the doctor can check the patient remotely. And the patient can should not there is no necessity for the patient to reach the hospital, or there is no necessity for the doctor to reach the patient home. So they can be there with their place, and they can monitor, and they can exchange their data, and they can have their clarifications. So all these things will be coming under the telemedicines. So in telemedicines also there are emerging technologies like smart telemedicine applications, smart diagnostic system for specific disease. So with this telemedicine, sir, telemedicines, for example, if you take if you take malaria or polio, if you take polio, this is nowadays there is no polio because they have been cured this polio by giving vaccinations. So this is one thing we can say it as a solution for specific disease. Like that, by having this telemedicines, we can find it out what is the specific what is the solution for a specific data. It means that we want to collect the data from overall areas, and we want to classify it, and we want to check, we want to classify according to the age, gender. So what is the cause factor for them to get this disease, and how they have death, because of this, how people, how many people have died because of this. This is all this total analysis will be done and the data will be stored. So whenever there is need for taking out the data, we can take it out from the system. So that is called as the smart diagnostic, and we are finding out the solution for that specific disease, elderly and the assistive technologies, because this is the area where everywhere is focusing. So while in India we are not in position to take care of taking care of our elder people. That's why we are making our people to be in the about many people are making their old people to be in the old home age, and there is no people to take care of, or sometimes they may have some worries, all these things. So there is no proper way to monitor this elderly people, and we are not giving importance. They feel that we are not giving importance to them. So in order to avoid all these things, they are monitored continuously by using these devices, that is by using this telemedicine. So that is they can make themselves the call to the doctor, and they can have they can say what they are having and what is doing for them, and they can get prescriptions from the doctor, and they can buy for themselves. Even if you are making call to paramedical shop or to some medical shop, they are having the home delivery. So all these things is called as your telemedicines. All these will be coming under your telemedicines. The next part we are going to see is that how the smart sensors is used in the Internet of Medical Things, that is IOMT. So we have heard about IoT, then AI. Nowadays we are depending upon this machine learning or deep learning, all these things. So this is also another emerging area of smart sensors, that is Internet of Medical Things. So it is somewhat advanced of your wearable device. So here we will be using from diapers, so what we are using for a small baby to elder people, even from the diaper to plasters. If there is any wound we had cut, then we are going for a plasters. So how these plasters are being used, all these things will be coming under this Internet of Medical Things. So there are so many existing sensor development in this Internet of Medical Things. One among that is called as your deep breath, that is called as the thorax monitoring system. So so this is used to monitor the baby who is having breathing problem. So the baby will be so small, the infant will be so small, so that we can't touch that baby then and often, because it may get infection. So the baby may get suffer from infection. So we should not disturb that baby. So we want to monitor the breathing of that baby also. So how we are going to monitor? So this was found it out. This method was found. This product was found out by that Fraunhofer Institute of Production and Technology Automation. So this is a Germany-based company. So here they are depending upon the free sensors, which is based on the radio technology. So the baby will be placed like this in the cradle. So two sides they will be placing antennas at the chest position. So two antennas will be placed at the chest position. So that electrodes which is in the chest, that is because more liquid will be there. If we are suffering from continuous cough, the people who is having asthma, wheezing problem, they will be having more liquid at the lungs. That's why they often have that they cough, all these things, cold, all these things, and they will be having breathing problems where they can't survive during the winters, because the liquid level inside the lungs will be increased. So in order to monitor that liquid level, in order to check the respirations, they have kept two antennas here, and these two antennas will be monitored continuously through a system. If there is any abnormalities given, it is immediately given to the nursing department, and the nurse will be taking care of this. So this is one type of IoT medical device. Okay, so that is called as deep breath, which was found by this Infra Institute of Production Technology and Automation. It is a Germany-based company. So the next comes the magic wand. So it is based on it is it was found by this Medwand Solutions. So this magic wand is also used to diagnostic fully to diagnose our body fully. So if there is any fault in my body, if there is any infection in my eyes, it can able to monitor. If there is any change in my weight, it can able to monitor. If I am doing my physical exercise heavily, it will monitor everything. So how it will be looking is that it will be looking like the mouse which we are using in our computer. So our mouse is a little bit a handheld mouse, but this magic wand will be little bit a big mouse. Okay, so you can keep like this in front of our eyes so that our sensors will observe our total body. And what is the thing we want to follow here is that we want to follow the way, the procedure, what the doctor is saying for us. Yes, so then only the doctor can able to monitor us step by step. This is one thing. If we are placing one thing, we can able to find it out whether any problem is that. If we are keeping that if we are keeping that mouse on the chest, then it can able to find it out the heart rate, the functioning of heart, the functioning of the lungs, everything. If we are keeping on the abdomen, on our stomach layer, then it can able to find it out any abnormalities in the stomach. So it is like a mouse like device which is able to monitor us fully. Yes, so it is also able to measure the temperature and the oxygen concentration in the blood level. Yes, so it will be connected to an ECG signal. You will be having a single channel ECG, so it will be connected to the ECG and we can able to see our heart rate also. The next is that a robot, that is one example what they have said with where they have been used is that in Thailand they have been used during this COVID-19. That is because many people, many in public areas, there will be more crowd will be there in order to avoid that infection of that disease. They have been used in a robot, so it will scan the people. Okay, who is not wearing the mask, and the people who is having body temperature, abnormal body temperature, everything it will be analyzed. And nearby that it has an another robot where they have been used ultraviolet radiation. But used on this ultraviolet radiation, it sanitizes the whole shopping mall or maybe or hospitals or that shop departmental stores, whatever it may be. So it has been sanitized by using this UV ultraviolet radiations. So in Asia, this is one of the first light source, that is by AI controlled robot to irradiate the people. Yes, not coming up. So it is one of the place I want to show that picture. Yes, yeah, the picture is there. Yes, you can able to see there is a four leg robot. It is like a dog. So it is used to detect the virus and kill the virus. But what is the energy stored here is that it was stored by that energy which has been filled in the hospital. So the energy has the ability to kill the DNA virus. That is, it can able to destroy the DNA virus. Okay, so it is also used to fight against the MRSA germs in the hospital. In 2025, what China has been planned is that to implement this type of robot in all healthcare sectors in order to take over the people's, as they have an insufficient of doctors in China. Yes, so they have planned like this. So another the thing we are going to see is the smart diaper, which is designed by this the Maharashtra Institute of Technology. So here they are using RFID chip to the diameter of 1 meter. So whenever the diaper gets wet, the information will be sent to the nursing, and the nurse can do for her, or they can change the diaper. It is mainly used for small babies, child, and for the elderly people who can't do their work by themselves. Yes. So the next comes the sugar snapshot. So you can see a button like a button like a kit. So it can be placed at the back of our arm. Yes, and you can scan it. So by using the scan, you can able to check the glucose level of our body. It is an invasline type because there is no there will not be any pain. You can't feel any pain. So it is an invasive one. So here you will be having the patches. So that a patch should be changed at every 12 weeks once. Okay, so when you get the amount, you can change the patch by every 12 weeks. That a snapshot can be stored and you can have the at a continuous monitoring of our blood vessels. It is this sugar snapshot was invented by or how was designed by this Abbott Freestyle Libre, and it is a waterproof device. So you can have after you can place like this and you can have your bath, and after 30 minutes if you check your glucose level, it will be having. So it is also a waterproof. Yes. So the next one you are going to see is that fever patch. So this is you can see the picture, I think so. So see that that you can able to see a skin like patch is placed at the arm under armpit. Yes, and so after that, after above that patch, she is having a mobile. So this is used to check about the temperature of our body. Yes, so this is called as the fever patch. So it was designed by the SteadySense. So this SteadySense is also designed for another type of sensor called as that FemSense. So FemSense is also used to check the ovulation of a female. So whether they are in correct fertilizations or whether they are having infertilization or whether they are having fertilizations. So this is also used for finding out the fertility of the females. Yes, so these are the areas where the smart sensors has been merged today. Not only in these areas, apart from these, there are so many applications in medical field based on the smart sensors. That is, if you want to use if you want to change the color of the screen of that windows in the room, you can give a signal to the nurse or doctors. Then if the people who is coming inside the room, they will be having a sensor which is placed at the entrance of the room. So the people who is having above the normal temperature, they are not supposed to get inside. The alarm will be beeping, sound will be there. So there are so many smart sensors. Still it is invented and it was designed and it was differ from the previous one. And most thing what we want to keep it in our mind is that the sensors what we are designing, it should be afforded by all the peoples who is in the low level peoples, middle low class peoples, middle class peoples, and higher class peoples. That is simply we can say it, all the device what we are going to design should be cost effectively, because many peoples who are not in position to afford money for treatment or all these things. So it should be designed such that it should be economical for all peoples. Yes, I think I have given an overview of smart sensors, how the smart sensors have been used in the medical field. Not only this, so I have covered only a little percentage, that is 1 or 2% of smart sensors what we have been used. There are so many sensors like what I have said, no automated wheelchairs or there. So wheelchairs, by using this wheelchairs, you can use you can ride that staircase. So in wheelchair you will be having a gear like structure. So when you when the staircase is sensed, automatically the gear wheel will be opened and they can travel the staircase without other without depending upon others. And another one type of wheelchair is there, that is there is a third leg. So whenever any up and downs in the street is there, the automatically the third wheel which is at the back will be make the wheelchair to move front. So there are so many sensors there in medical device, like not only in medical, we are not only in medical field, sorry, not only for other human beings, but this smart sensors can also be used in veterinaries, that is for animals also, that is nowadays they are using for animals depending upon this 3D printing. 3D printing is also in another merging area where we can have all designs of our arms by using this biomechanisms. So if I want to have a movement like this, I want to design my arm in all XYZ directions. So all these will be coming under the biomechanisms. And based on this biomechanism rehabilitation process, the same thing is happening in the veterinary line, that is making the replacement for an elephant, that is they have made replacement for a leg replacement for an elephant, then a beak replacement for an eagle, then feather that for the feather replacement for a parrot. So there are so many things. Bionic eyes, I can say bionic eyes is another example for the smart sensors. Then electronic tongue, hearing aids. So there are so many merging areas in medical field. Hope I have given an idea or an overall overview of how the smart sensors have been used in a medical field. Yes, thank you all, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now, question and answer session. Any questions from the participants? Okay, ma'am. I'd like to express my gratitude to our expert resource person, Dr. G. Sudha, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
For delivering smart sensors to the participants of the AACDE Teaching and Learning Adel Academy sponsored 1 week online faculty development program on smart sensors technology at the GPRAC. Thank you very much, ma'am, for your kind support.
Thank you, sir.
Dear participants, the next session will be at 2:30. Please bear the time delay. We'll start at 2:30. Yes. Thank you, ma'am. You can
thank you. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.